Hello, hello! In today's video, I will show you how to create incredible images right from the comfort of your home using your personal AI server. Forget relying on the cloud or worrying about free tool limits. You will have everything you need at the fingertips by installing and configuring Stable Diffusion. If you've seen my previous video where I explained how to set up a home AI server using Ollama and OpenWeb UI, we'll now taking it to the next level. We'll add image generation capabilities to that setup, keeping everything in one place. Haven't seen that video yet? Check the link in the description. Let's dive in. Let's get Stable Diffusion up and running. For this, we'll use automatic 111 web UI, which make it easy to manage and use this tool. But first, we need to install two things, Python and Git. So let's go to python.org and we need to install Python in version 3.10.6. Scroll down and choose version for your system. I use recommended version for Windows. Windows installer 64-bit. Open. And you should add Python 3.10 to path. Install now. This shouldn't take long time. Okay. Now let's go to Git. Click here to download. This should be a quick install. Next, 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 next. And finish. Okay. Now we can back to our Stable Diffusion web UI. Code. Okay, you can just download zip, but I will do copy because I want to use Git for easier management and updating. As you can see, I already created folder for my AI. I want install Stable Diffusion in this folder. So cmd, enter, and git clone and paste. Okay, ready. So let's go to Stable Diffusion web UI. And now, if you have Windows, you can just double click on web UI user. All right, now's the perfect time to grab your coffee. Maybe a big one, because this part's going to take a while. I will speed up the recording a bit and see you in a moment. Okay, after installing UI from Stable Diffusion should open automatically. If not, you can try localhost 7860. Okay, as you can see here, we have default checkpoint. Nothing special, but it's okay for start. Okay, now I will quickly discuss the most important elements. Okay, here you enter what you want to generate. And here what you don't want to generate. For example, if you don't want text on the image, enter here text. Here you set sampling steps. The more steps, the better the image, but the longer it takes to generate. Okay, I will show you what I mean. Okay, I generate the same image in 3 steps, 6, 9, 12, 24, 32, and 44. As you can see, more steps, better image. Here you set how many images you want to create and how many images you want to create in the same time. Here you can set the image size. The bigger the image, the longer it takes. Oh, and this CFG scale, this determines how closely the AI sticks to what you want to generate. If you set lower number, it sticks to the plan. But if you say high number, then, you know, you want cut, but whatever. I generate whatever I want. If you set here -1, you will get a different image every time. If you want to work on the image like I did before, work on the same sample, you have to change this. Okay. Generate. And this takes some time. Okay, it's not that great. If you want to generate a better image, then you should know that there are special models for generating different types of image. You can download them, for example, from this site. Okay, as you can see, the images are really great. And if you would like to create a similar one, you can also copy the prompt. Okay, but from the beginning, you download the checkpoint and you should go to models, stable diffusion, and paste here your checkpoints. As you can see, now I have not only the default one. So let's test this. Let's go back to stable diffusion, refresh, and now you should see new checkpoints. Paste prompt here and generate. Generate. Yeah, much better. Okay, let's test something new. Paste, generate. Wait for a moment. Not that great. If I click generate, sample diffusion, create new random image because I have seed minus one. As you can see, different image. Okay. If you want to work on the same sample and generate the same image, you should change this from minus one to something else. And now let's change sampling steps. As you can see, the same image, but much better. Okay, do you remember my AI server? So we can also add ability to generate images in this server. Admin panel. Settings. Images. And here you should choose automatic 111. Okay, now URL for stable diffusion is localhost 7860. Okay, but first, if you want to use Stable Diffusion in OpenWI, you should edit the web UI user file, edit, and set here API and listen. Okay, now we can run this file one more time. So you should see in this place API and listen. Now, as you can see, the URL is http://0007861. And that's okay, but I run OpenWebUI in Docker container. So I should in this place add IP of my local computer. So paste. And as you can see, server connection verified. Okay. Okay, let's try to generate something. For example, create prompt for stable diffusion for funny cat programmer. Let's wait a moment. Okay, this is our prompt. And now, as you can see, there is new icon. You can click on this, generate image, wait a moment. And ta-da! This is image generated by Stable Diffusion in OpenWebUI. Okay, that's all for today. If you enjoyed this video, smash the like button and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss new content. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.